You know, with our own Geraldo Rivera and Republican presidential candidate Tom Tancredo, look, as hard as I try, Congressman, to convince my colleague here, Geraldo, this is about, we had an opportunity. If we didn't have sanctuary cities, if we would check the status of people that arrested, in this case, you know, of, you know, the serial rape of a five-year-old girl, these kids would be alive. This goes to the heart of what the problem is here, is that we have a fear that we don't even look at the status of illegal immigrants.
This is exactly the case. It's got nothing to do with my grandparents. It's got nothing to do with Miami or Washington State. It's got everything to do with the fact that when somebody commits a crime in this country, and they are here illegally, they commit another crime, some heinous crime, and that is not reported to ICE, then they are allowed to go out on the street for whatever reason, bail or anything else, and commit another crime, in this case, the murder of three people, then you cannot escape responsibility.
Absolutely.
The sanctuary city of Newark has got to take responsibility for this.
Let me hold on a second. Let me get back to Geraldo. This is important. Now, I want you to... No, you can't just... I got to get this...
You'll like this.
Really quick. You're killing me here. You take over the...
I think that the issue as defined this evening will be the seminal issue in the 08 presidential race.
Whether
you agree with...
All right, now I got to get my question in. Here is my question.
Colorado or with me or
I want you to explain
that will be the election and where the majority will fall will
be. Look, the law of the land is
Do you agree with that?
The law of the land is
Do you agree with me?
The law of the land is you are not allowed to enter this country illegally.
Right.
We have these sanctuary cities which basically they won't check the status of people. You explain to me why we shouldn't do everything possible to enforce the law and why we would not check the status of criminals.
I can easily explain. You know, there are 12 million illegal aliens, quote-unquote. But you know what the crime is, first of all? It's a low-level federal misdemeanor that is usually treated as a civil violation. What if we criminalize, as Jim Sensenbrenner, Tom Tancredo's colleague, tried to do in 06, all of the illegals? 12 million. That is six times the total population of all the prisons in the United States of America.
How are you
going to
do it?
Six times.
Right, we only have a moment left.
So the 12 million, that's equal to the total population of New York and Los Angeles.
You got a great. Now we are
Congressman.
Let me ask you a hypothetical. We're talking about deporting people and finding them and getting them out.
Just a minute.
If a child, a six-year-old child with an infectious disease, goes to a hospital, should the hospital then find out if that child is here illegally, or you're going to drive people to actually stay home and not get treatment and go to school?
I'm not going to allow you to drive this issue, to drive this discussion away from the issue that we're here to talk about.
Three
dead children in Newark, one in the hospital. They're dead because the city of Newark has a sanctuary policy.
60 crimes
in Newark. That's the end of the story.
What you're choosing on
Tell you why. Because if the city of Newark had done its job and the federal government, these three kids would still be alive. That's
why this is an issue.
Do you understand that?
Other murders that took place in the same city. Why only this one?
Do you understand? Because we know that these three kids would still be alive today.
How many people enjoyed the benefit of a random act of kindness today from someone who was illegal? How many lives were saved? How many children were fed? How many people had their lives improved today by an undocumented immigrant?
You're extrapolating one horrible act out of 60 acts because the person's illegal. You want to use it as a political bat to hit your opponents over the head. That's what you're doing, Congressman.
Three kids would be alive today, Alan. Three would be alive.
That you're ignoring all the other murders.
Because that's the truth. Because that's the truth.
Thank you, Congressman, for being with us. Geraldo, by the way, don't forget, watch this weekend for his special, The Death of Diana, Unanswered Questions. It's on.